Before we begin our coverage of cost volume profit analysis, it is important that you remember what the contribution margin income statement is and understand what the contribution margin indicates. Now, if you'll recall, the contribution margin income statement classifies costs as variable or fixed and computes a contribution margin. The contribution margin is revenues minus variable cost. And so the definition of contribution margin is sales that remain after variable expenses have been deducted. Now, how that is used, it is to evaluate what is left to cover fixed costs and profit. The contribution margin, understand, can be a total amount, a per unit amount, or even a ratio. So we'll look at each of these three situations. The total contribution margin, you would take total sales minus total variable cost on the income statement. Per unit, you would start with the unit selling price and subtract the variable cost per unit. The contribution margin ratio is computed either on a per unit basis or a total dollar basis. And you will take contribution margin divided by sales. So it could be contribution margin per unit divided by sales price per unit, or total contribution margin divided by total sales dollars. On the other hand, the variable cost ratio can also be calculated in total or per unit. And the calculation is total variable cost over total sales dollars, or variable cost per unit divided by the sales price per unit. So once again, you'll get a percentage here. It is important to note that the contribution margin ratio and the variable cost ratio will make up 100% of your sales. So they are mathematical complements. So to review, here are your two income statement formats. The traditional format, which we will use in financial reporting, is sales minus cost of goods sold gives you gross margin minus operating expenses gives you income. The cost of goods sold is comprised of product cost, and the operating expenses are made up of period costs. So this is the product period format. The contribution margin income statement will take sales minus variable costs, which could be product or period costs. That will give you contribution margin minus fixed costs, which could be product or period cost, and that gives you income. So this is the variable fixed format, and it does emphasize cost behavior. Let's work an example to review the contribution margin income statement. Klein Manufacturing Corporation is the exclusive producer of a product that is experiencing growth in sales. Assuming the company is able to sell all units produced, the company's revenues and expenses for last month are given below. Sales, 4,000 units, $100,000. Variable cost, $40,000, made up of cost of goods sold and selling expenses. That gives us a contribution margin of $60,000. Fixed overhead is $10,000. Fixed selling and administrative, $26,000. Total fixed cost, $36,000. And net operating income, $24,000. Based on the contribution margin ratio, how much will profits increase if 400 additional units are produced and sold for $10,000? So we must first compute the contribution margin ratio, since the problem did ask us to base our calculation on that. The contribution margin ratio will be the contribution margin of $60,000 divided by the sales of $100,000, or 60%. We can now assume that once we break even, 60% of every sales dollar will be profit. So if increase in profit, if sales increase by $10,000, should be $10,000 times 60%, or $6,000. So after we break even, 60% of every sales dollar is profit. Now notice that all of these sales dollars will not be profit because every time you sell an additional unit, variable costs are incurred. So we will have more materials cost, but not rent. If 60% is the contribution margin, then 40% is our variable cost ratio. So 40% of this extra $10,000 or $4,000 will go toward covering variable costs. Prepare an income statement for the month using the contribution margin format if 4,400 units are sold. So in the original information, you can recall 4,000 units are reflected in your sales and cost levels. If we want to recompute this income statement at 4,400 units, we have to recognize that the sales will increase, so we need to get the sales price per unit. If sales were $100,000 for 4,000 units, the sales price was $25. We'll also need to adjust our variable costs because by definition, these will change. Our cost of goods sold was $8 per unit at the sales level of 4,000 units, and our variable selling cost was $2 per unit. The fixed cost will not change, so there is no need to compute the per unit amounts. Now we'll take these numbers and recalculate the income statement. 4,400 units times $25 for sales. Cost of goods sold will be 4,400 units times 8. Variable selling will be 4,400 units times 2. And the fixed cost will remain at 36,000. So here's what it will look like. Sales will be $110,000. Variable cost, first, our variable cost of goods sold will be 8 times 4,400 or $35,200. Variable selling expenses will be $8,800 and the contribution margin will be $66,000. Our fixed costs will remain at $10,000 and $26,000. So income will be $30,000. Now this part two simply proves that if sales increase by $10,000, profit will increase by $6,000. You get the same increase whether you use the contribution margin ratio or recalculate the income statement. Now we'll be using the contribution margin format income statement off and on throughout the rest of the semester, and we'll also need to understand how to use the contribution margin and the contribution margin ratio. So learn it well.